kita nyoba.
Okay, let's pray. Let's pray. Our Father in heaven, we surrender, Lord, our time to you. I surrender, Lord, my voice, my influence, my emphasis. Please guide us, Lord. Send the Holy Spirit to possess us, Lord, so that we may understand your word, Lord. Give us wisdom and understanding, our my brethren here, as we try to digest your word, Lord. We praise you, Lord, for the nice music. We praise you, Lord, for the truth for our church, Lord. Thank you for hearing our prayers. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. I praise the Lord, brothers and sisters, for the nice music. You know, several months, English po Tagalog? Taglish. Okay. Several months ago, I was at IAS. Just attending the church, the opening of the EGY estate, and Dr. James Nix from the General Conference was there, sir. And he was in the afternoon. We had there was a program speaker. The title of the program was Songs in Zion. Sabi ko, ano kaya yung Songs in Zion na yun? Dun pala, ang introduction niya, Ellen G. White saw heavenly music in her visions and in her dreams. And sometimes when she has very heavy burden, spiritual burden as a messenger of the Lord, she hears at night when she sleeps, nice heavenly music. And then when she wakes up in the morning, sabi niya sa mga apo niya, mga anak niya, narinig niyo ba yung music kagabi? Siyempre hindi nila narinig dahil si Ellen G. White lang nakarinig. So, if you want to know what is heavenly music, it's very easy. Just see what are the music or the styles of music that Ellen G. White wanted to teach to her church. So, gumawa si James White ng hymnal, kinumpile lahat ng mukhang heavenly music at nilagay doon. At meron silang connection. And we sang all of those favorite hymns of Ellen G. White and James White in that afternoon. About 2 hours, we are just playing the piano and trying to sing the notes and the hymns there. So, yun ang pinaka positive way to teach what heavenly music is. Hindi, usually kasi ina-atake yung mga iba. So that is the very nice. So mabuti na lang dito sa church. As far as I know, it looks like heavenly music. Pero sabi rin ni Sister White, do not sing funeral songs daw. Natuwa naman yung mga charismatic na mga tao. Oh, dapat lively. Pero nung kumanta na kami, hymnal pala sir. Mga hymns ang ibig niya sabihin. So, dahil hindi niyo po ako kilala, I rejoice. Anyway, I saw the Seventh-day Adventist Church at the back. Dun. So, ako po yung magpapakilala. I am happy to be here, even if I don't know many of you. But I know that we all believe in the same things. Number one, the Holy Scriptures and our scripture reading is to the law and to the testimony. If they speak not according to this word, which is the Bible, it is because there is no light in them. In Tagalog po, yung according ay ayon. Okay, let me give you an example. If I say, I like orange. Okay, and then you say, Serwin likes orange. Is that according? Yes. Right? If I say, I like orange, but you say, Serwin likes banana, is it according? No. But is it contradiction? Not necessarily. Maybe I like both, right? But not necessarily contradiction. If I say, I don't like banana, and then you say, Serwin likes banana, that is contradiction, right? So, according is very strict. It has to be positively advertised in the Bible, right? So, when we say, okay, let me cut it short because the time is very fast. Bakit hindi tayo nagbibinyag ng sanggol? Meron bang nakasulat sa Bible na bawal magbinyag ng sanggol? Wala. Pero, hindi natin ginagawa dahil hindi siya ayon. Oh, ganyan ka-stricto ang beliefs ng Seventh-day Adventist Church. hindi natin hinahanap lahat ng hindi bawal. Ang hinahanap natin, lahat ng positively ayon. Oh, galing. Nakalagay ba sa Bible, bawal ilipat ang sanctity ng Sabbath sa ibang araw? Hindi, direkta. Sa prophecy, pwedeng paikot-ikotin. Pero, bakit hindi natin nilipat sa Linggo? Kasi hindi ayon. Ang ayon sa Biblia, Sabado, tayo magsimba. Lahat po ng ating fundamental beliefs ay ayon. Ganyan ka-istrikto. Kaya, ganyan tayo ka-istrikto. Hindi natin hinahanap lahat ng, hindi naman yan pinagbabawal. Hindi naman yan pinagbabawal. Hindi. Ang pinaka-istrikto, the safest, is a clear, sabi sa Great Controversy, sa chapter na the Word of God, there will be a people on this earth in the last days that will have the Bible and the Bible only as their basis of all reform and doctrines, and our demand should be a clear for all doctrines and precepts. Our demand should be a clear, thus saith the Lord. Pag malinaw sa Bible na sinasabi, gawin yan, yan ang dapat gawin. Totoo. Amen? Ayon, in English, according. Pinag-difference ko lang yung contradiction at saka according. Lahat ng contradiction ay hindi according. Pero hindi lahat ng hindi according ay contradiction. Ang pinaka-safe ay yung ayon, yung according mismo. Okay, very good. Diyan, pag naintindihan natin yung according na yan, madali lang. Kasi pinag-aawayan, pinag-didiscussan ngayon ng ating church, ang women ordination. Sabi natin, hanapin lang nyo sa Bible. Sasabihin na ba ng iba, hindi naman yan pinagbabawal. Oh, ganun bang ating hermeneutic? Hinahanap natin yung hindi bawal at pwede natin gawin? Hindi. Ang ating hermeneutic ay, kung ano yung ginagawa doon, yun. Di ba? Si Cain, sinabihan ba siya ng Diyos, bawal mag-offer ng vegetables? Hindi. Bakit nagkamali siya pag-offer ng vegetables? Kasi hindi yun ayon. So, ang kaaway, may mga fake na mga bagay na hindi ayon. Fake na worship, fake na relationships, fake na marriage, lalaki-lalaki, babae-babae, tatlo pa minsan, at saka kung ano-ano, fake na worship day, fake na music, ano pa, fake na food. Okay. Pero, magaling na daw kayo dun dito, sabi ni Ismael. So, okay, so yun ang ating hermeneutic. That's how we understand the Bible. And lahat ito, yung Trinity. Bakit hindi natin makita yung Trinity sa Bible? Kasi, that is a word. Yung description ng word. Hanapin natin sa, kaya galit yung mga anti-Trinitarian. Wala naman Trinity sa Bible. So, pero, nandyan, sabi ni Pastor Parulan, the idea is there, di ba? Words describe ideas. Ideas are representations of the truth. And the truth about God cannot fit in the dictionary, cannot fit in our mind. But the Bible has descriptions. And kung ano yung nakasulat doon, baptized in the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Ghost. So, ibig sabihin, nandun. And sabi sa writings ni Ellen G. White, we affirm, we get our doctrines from the Bible. We affirm our interpretation with the writings of Ellen G. White. Sabi sa writings of Ellen G. White, the third person. Ibig sabihin, tatlo. Persona. Okay. Kasama dyan ang God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit was sent by Jesus Christ when He left. Okay, the Holy Spirit was already inspiring Isaiah, Jeremiah, Moses, and the Holy Spirit is our comfort. And Jesus said, the Holy Spirit will teach you all things. Kasama din yung revelation, di ba? The revelation of Jesus Christ. So the revelation of Jesus Christ is from Jesus Christ. How did it reach? See, turo ba ni Jesus Christ? And of course, Jesus, God the Father, they sent the revelation through the Holy Spirit to John the Revelator. And also to the later prophet like Ellen G. White. We also believe in creation. There, because alam nyo kung bakit nakasulat sa Genesis, in the evening and the morning, in the evening and the morning, in the evening and the morning. Kasi may mga nag-iisip ngayon, 1,000 years daw yung isang araw sa creation. Paano maging 1,000 years yun? May evening and morning. Di ba? So 500 years na evening, 500 years na morning. Mabuti na lang alam ng Diyos na magkakaroon ng idea ng ganun. Kaya inulit-ulit yung evening and morning, evening and morning. And kung walang 7-day literal creation, saan nakabase yung ating Sabbath? So, yan ang ginagawa ng kaaway, tinatanggal ang creation, binabalik ang pinapalit ang evolution. But praise the Lord, kahit na medyo nakalog yung isa sa ating institution, yung La Sierra, meron sa ating church mga scholars, mga binigyan ng Diyos ng katalinuhan na profession sa Bible, sa archaeology, at saka sa biology. So authoritative sila sa tatlong fields, and they have PhD in many fields, and when they speak, they know which science is bogus, which Bible verse is not corrected, not interpreted correctly, and so on. And we affirm creation. And we also believe the nature of man, we were created perfect, but because of sin, God's image was marred, but God is restoring to us the original image. We also believe in the great controversy. Mabuti na lang ang katapusan ng great controversy. It is finished. Oh, tapos na. Alam na kung sinong panalo. Kakampi na lang tayo. The great controversy, the issue is worship. The issue is the character of God. And ang question ng kaaway, hindi pwedeng masunod ang Ten Commandments. Ang posisyon ni Jesus Christ, pwede. Posisyon ng kaaway, hindi. We are putting in question, they are putting in question the character, the law of God. But Jesus says, Jesus was an example for us in His life and His death that it is possible to follow and obey the law of God. And, humanap tayo ng ibang religion na buhay ang hero? Wala. Christian lang ang buhay ang hero. Pero maraming faith na Christianity. Okay, yung mga they call upon the name but they do not obey. Oh, okay. And we also believe in the experience of salvation. There is justification when we ask for forgiveness when we are baptized. Sanctification, that's why even if we are old already, we still have to read the Bible, the spirit of prophecy, the counsels, the diet and food. Diba? Hirap basahin nun. Madali lang tingnan, pero mahirap basahin. And kahit na si Moses nakapatay sa Egypt, siya pa rin ang ginamit ng Diyos na magkarga ng Ten Commandments na may nakasulat, thou shalt not kill. Tatanong ba kayo, bakit hindi na lang ibang pinili ng Diyos na kumarga ng Ten Commandments? Si Moses pa na nakalabag ng thou shalt not kill. Bakit hindi na lang ibang apostle ang inassign niyang Diyos na sumulat ng almost half ng New Testament book? Si Saul pa na naging Pablo ang sumulat ng almost half ng New Testament books. Ibig sabihin, ganyan ang miracle ng salvation. Though our sins be as scarlet, they shall be made white as snow. Grabe. Kung hindi dahil dyan, wala tayo dito lahat sa church. Okay, very nice. Salvation. So, dahil, because God loves us, God forgives our sin, God wants us to give us eternal life, no problem to obey the law, right? We are not saved by obeying the law. We are not saved by the Ten Commandments. We are not saved by keeping the Sabbath. Are you sure? We are not saved by vegetarianism. We are saved from sickness, maybe. But we are not saved salvation-wise by these things. We are not saved by not smoking. We are not saved by keeping Sabbath. We are saved by Jesus Christ. Grace. By grace are we saved through faith, not of ourselves. It is the gift of God. But we obey because of our reaction, our love for God, right? Pinatawad na nga tayo ng ating maraming kasalanan. Ayaw pa nating sumunod? Oo, di ba? So that's the idea why we obey, because of our response to God's love for us. When we understand God's love, God's salvation, walang mahirap gawin. Alam nyo, when you read the great controversy, you know why they did those things, mga martyr? Because God's salvation is very important. They died for this word, for the Bible. Because the most important thing is to be saved. Okay, tanungin niya yung mga malapit ng mamatay. Kung anong pinaka-importante. Buhay na walang hanggan. Lalo pag hindi mo na sigurado ikaw ay mabubuhay pa. Ang pinaka-importante ay maligtas. Yun talaga mga kapatid, ang pinaka-importante. And, yung pinakabago nating fundamental belief, yung growing in Christ. You know why I like the fundamental beliefs? It assures you I'm not an offshoot. And it reminds us what we are supposed to believe, right? Growing in Christ, the first half of that means that we are not afraid of multo, because Romans 8 says, nor powers, nor principalities, Nothing can separate us from the love of God. The other half is that we have to continue reading and sanctification. Okay, that's growing in Christ. And we have the church from Adam until now. Everybody who genuinely believes in Jesus Christ is part of the church. Okay, and there is also a remnant. Nung sila Adam, nagkasala, remnant, Abraham. Sila Abraham, nagkasala, remnant, Noah. Sino yung anak ni Noah, loko-loko na rin, remnant, Israel, Jacob. Sino bang nauna? Baliktad yata. Si Abraham. No, ang Israel, pinapatay nila si Jesus Christ, remnant, Christians. Christians followed tradition, remnant, Protestants. Protestants were supposed to know, continue, you know, revival, going back to the word. They stopped there. But the group who just continued to learn and everything that is according to the word is the Seventh-day Adventist Church, founded in the right date. So we have a remnant. We find ourselves in prophecy, the people who keep the commandments of God and have the testimony of Jesus Christ. That's why we have testimonies 1 to 9. Yung ibang church na found noong revival period, meron din silang testimony, pero kunti lang. Yung sa atin, ang dami. And of course, they don't keep all the commandments. Okay. And we are united in the body of Christ, different colors, different talents. Yan. Jesus Christ unites us. That's why I want to pray before I speak. And I want to pray for you before I speak, because when we all connect to God, synchronize our minds to God, we are united. Kaya daw tayo nag-away-away minsan dahil hindi natin kinoconnect ang ating sarili sa vine. Without connection to Jesus Christ, we can do nothing. And of course, we believe in biblical baptism because it is according to the word. We also believe in the Lord's Supper. We do it because Jesus said we should do it. And spiritual gifts and ministries. Some people are good in violin, in piano. And you know, you never know how hard these things are until you try to do it. Right? It's like sometimes, I think morality is like playing the violin. You hear the MP3, you see the notes, and you know how it's supposed to go, but when you try, something else happens. Parang buhay pananampalataya. Alam mo kung anong tama, alam mo kung anong nakasulat, nakita mo yung example. Pero, minsan, bakit ganun? Kailangan ng practice. Oh, practice makes permanent. Oh, pag mali yung practice, mali yung permanent. Permanently wrong. Pero pag tama yung practice, kaya may teacher. To in the spiritual life, there is a teacher. God is the teacher. And God rebukes us when we are wrong, right? Kanina umaga, love. You know, often I have arguments about love. You should be more loving. And then there's a quotation from Ellen G. White that says, Jesus never uttered a word without love. Oh, really? If Ellen G. White is a true prophet, and Jesus Christ is also, of course, true, then how can we reconcile when Jesus said, "Kayo, you sir, you sons of the devil, sons of your father, the devil"? How can that be out loud or with love? The only way to reconcile those things is to change our idea about love. Love is very big. It includes rebuke. Proverbs says, "Whom I love, I rebuke and chasten him. Therefore, be zealous and repent." So rebuke, even if it hurts, is love. Ganyan mo lang mapapatunayan na tama si Ellen G. White, na God loves. Jesus uttered every word with love, even if it was very sharp, it was still with love. And that, the sharp things Jesus said in the Bible. Okay, spiritual gifts and ministries and the gift of prophecy, because 7 Joel 2:28, in the last, it shall come to pass, I will pour my spirit upon all flesh. That's why ang daming nag-outreach ngayon. Sa Acts 2:17-21, dinagdagan lang po ng in the last days. It shall come to pass in the last days, I will pour out my spirit unto all flesh, and men, young men and daughters shall prophesy. That's why yung mga prophets, merong mga babaeng prophets, kahit walang ordained na sa Bible. Prophets, pwede. So Ellen G. White says, I was not ordained. But Ellen G. White is a prophet, right? And even, you know, the whole Adventist church has a prophetic calling. We are supposed to be prophets to the Gentiles. So don't be false prophet. Be true prophet. Because the punishment of a false prophet in the Old Testament is death. When you say something and then it happens, and then you say something to lead people away from God, your punishment is death. And in the last days, Matthew 24, there will be many false prophets will call themselves Christians, but they are not teaching according. Kaya I tell my friends, when you preach in front, do not mention anything that's not in the Bible and the SOP. Otherwise, somebody will prove you wrong someday. Okay. So, we read, and the gift of the Holy Spirit is prophecy, and there are big prophets and small prophets. Our very big prophet on the last days is Sister Ellen G. White, right? So, you know, there is an idea of most recent instruction. Meron kaming kaibigan na mayaman. Siguro kailala niyo rin. Sabi niya nung bago pa siyang binyag, ayaw kong tanggalin ang aking mga hikaw. Kasi sa Bible, meron daw crown. Meron daw sa Bible, earrings. Meron daw sa Bible din, so langit may crown din. And may pearls. So, ayaw niya tanggalin. Sabi ko, the way to understand this, oh ano, hindi tuloy makasagot yung, ay, what happened? Noong lumabas yung Israel sa Egypt, sabi ng Diyos, lusubin niyo yan. Ayaw namin. Hindi nila nilusob. Tapos sabi, lusubin namin. Sabi ng Diyos, wag. Nilusob nila. Nangamatay sila. So, ang question, which is God's will? Lumusob o hindi lumusob? Depende kung kailan. Most recent instruction, right? If God says lumusob, you lusob. If God says don't lusob now, don't lusob now. If God says you lusob tomorrow, you lusob tomorrow. The most recent instruction, right? One thing. Abraham, God told Abraham, come out. Go out and go to Canaan. Tama ba? To a land you don't know. So he went out. And then when it was famine, he said, you go to Egypt with Joseph. So they went to Egypt. And then when Egypt was, God told the Israelites, you come out of Egypt. Kontra-kontra ba ang will ng Panginoon? Bakit sabi niya pumunta sa Egypt? Mamaya pumunta naman sa Canaan. But pabalik-balik. The most recent instruction, right? We have to obey the most recent instruction. Kasi yung iba, gusto ko sundin yun kasi mas pabor sa akin yung naunang instruction. Pero ang most recent instruction, ganito. So, ano yung most recent instruction sa mga hikaw? Kung may crown sa Bible, then there is crowns. Kung may crown sa heaven, then there is crowns. But what is the most recent instruction from the Bible? Sa First Peter, sa Peter 3:3. Adorn yourselves not with this thing and this thing. Oh, di ba? But by the internal adorning of the character. Okay. So the most recent instruction is the most recent instruction from the prophets that we believe, including Sister White. Okay. Aha. Nahuli kayo doon, ano? Including Sister White. Okay? Dinunod ko lang po. Ah, okay lang. Bungi yung isang wire. Anyway, it's okay. It's just black and white. I will not put any colors. So, the law of God does not save us, but it is the character of God written, the Ten Commandments, and we all memorize the law of God. Oh, man, I want to say things that are not very popular. Sabi sa law of God, thou shalt not kill. Sabi ni Jesus, that's why do not utter words that hurt. Oh, kaya pala dapat maayos lang yung ating sinasalita. In fact, we will be judged by our idle words. Sabi sa Ten Commandments, thou shalt not steal. Ah, kaya pala, hindi tayo nagpa-pirate ng... hindi. Para madaling maintindihan niyo. Hindi natin pinapaserox yung mga books ng LE. Do you understand? Do you understand, right? Because you can relate. You have LEs who are friends. You don't want to xerox copy their books because kakaya naman sa kanila. May nakasulat doon, copyright. Diba? So what copyright means, protects the publishers and the authors because mahirap magsulat ng book. Diba? So copyright. How about software? Oh! Ah! Wala kayong kaibigan software engineer. Kaya hindi nyo feel. Right? You don't know that it's hurting me. I am a programmer, computer science department. But we have to be good example.
Oh, positive na lang, hindi na atake.
We have to be good example. That's why we do not just copy MP3 if we do not have digital rights, right? And movies also, right? Because we have to be good example. Who else will obey the Ten Commandments? Do not steal from Bill Gates. Okay. Diba? Mabuti na lang, may mga free. Kung hindi kayang bumili, huwag nang gumamit. Humarap ng libre. Ngayon nyo lang ata narinig yan. Sige lang. Thou shalt not commit adultery. Kaya huwag titingin dun sa mga ang pananamit ay katulad sa mall. Oh, buti na lang yung choir natin. Very good example. Praise the Lord. Ahanap tayo ng gagayahan. Ayaw ko nang atakihin yung mga ano. Kasi sabi ni Ellen G. White, even if their clothes is not correct, do not tell them to go away from church. It's better they are here in church with wrong clothes than they are out of the church they cannot hear. But we want to give the good example. Right? Kaya sa writings ni Ellen G. White, most recent instruction, remember, merong tatlong group ng babae na tumawid sa kanyang paningin. Yung isa, sobrang mahaba ng damit, nakasayad sa floor, nalilinisan yung floor. Hindi daw po yung tama. Yung pangalawa, sobrang ikli. Ay, mahirap sabihin to. Pero, aalis naman ako mamayang hapon. Sobrang ikli. It does not reach the knee. Yung ibang kaibigan ko, reach the knee. Pero pag umupo, not reach anymore. Minsan may baliktad din. Pag nakatayo, it does not reach. Pag nakaupo, it reach. Depending on how you pull. But if you want to be sure, make sure it nandun sa pangatlo, yung pangatlo tama. Pangatlo tama. Sabi ni Sister White, it is about as long as where the gaiter boot is. G-A-I-T-E-R. Sabi ko, ano yung gaiter boot? So, tinayip ko sa Google Images, gaiter boot. Hanggang dito. Anong klaseng gaiter boot yun? Di conflict. Tinayip ko, gaiter boot 1800s. Hanggang dito. Iba pala yung gaiter boot ngayon at saka yung gaiter boot noon. Muntik na. Most recent instruction. Pero hindi, most recent gaiter boot. Okay. Kung susundin kasi yung most recent gaiter boot, magko-conflict yun dun sa it does not reach the knee. So hindi na siya coherent, right? Okay, that's why, because when you wear those things, it is inviting adultery. The Bible says when a man looks at a woman lustfully, he is committing adultery with himself. No, with you. So walang adultery mag-isa. Hindi lang yung lalaki nag-adultery in her mind. Kasama ka. Oh. Okay, since you didn't know, God forgives, right? But now you know, tomorrow you are going to the mall and look for all, right? Very good. Because God loves us. Wala bang mahirap kapalit ang kaligtasan. Di ba? Kaligtasan na ngayon binibigay sa'yo ng Diyos. Mahirap bang sundin ang mga propeta ng Diyos? Hindi. Kahit ano pa. Di ba? Okay. Ito. That's why we all here. Kita niyo po ba? Sabbath. In the Sabbath. That's why, ito po, mabigat po ito. Pasin niyo seatbelt. Sabi ng Diyos kay Moses, bawal magluto sa Sabado. Basahin natin. Mali. I am the Lord your God who kept you out from Egypt. I'll give you manna 6 days. You collect twice as many in the sixth day. And this is what the Lord has said. Sino nagsabi? Yung Pharisee, si Moses, o ang Diyos? Ang Diyos. Si Ellen G. White? Ang Diyos. Tomorrow is the rest of the Holy Sabbath unto the Lord. Bake that which you will bake today and seethe that which you will seethe. Ano yung bisa ng seethe? Pakuluan. Bake. Ano, sir? Okay lang. Favorite. Yeah, okay, thank you. Really? May nagluto ba sa Bible ng Sabado? Meron. Yung priest sa loob ng sanctuary. Niluto nila yung shewbread every Sabbath. Pero sa labas, wala. Wala akong alam. Pero baka meron kayong nalalaman. Kaya pala mga kapatid, bago kayo banatan ng banatan, bibigyan ko muna kayo ng example para matanggal lahat ng excuse. Kaya pala, sa New York City's Clabat o Mount Clabat College, yung cafeteria nila, niluluto ang marami, hindi perfect. At least they try. They try to cook most of the viands Friday. And so, Sabado, sabi ng President, nandun sa International Student Services Conference sa IAS, which I, by God's grace, attended. In our campus, we do not allow jogging on Sabbath. Why? Because, you know, some people say, jogging makes you healthy. So, you know, you should be able to do it. But if we allow jogging, we should also allow badminton. Because badminton is makes you healthy also. Diba? That's why we don't allow. If you jog there, the security guard will arrest you. And he was complaining about his teachers who don't go to church. Then he interviewed his teachers. Why don't you go to church? Sir, we are tired. We are cooking. Oh, you are cooking on Friday night? Oh. So I was wondering, oh, it's not only in the Philippines. That's the problem. Sabi naman ni Pastor Sinaga, ng SSD Associate Secretary, doon naman sa 2014 Asian, IAS Asian Theological Forum. Sabbath keeping. And he just agreed with the Adventist.org website. He says, alam niyo nakasulat sa Adventist.org official website? Preparation, buying and preparation of food should be done before the Sabbath, including plancha and gasoline, you know, these things. Okay. Tapos sabi naman nung nakita naman ako ni Sir Paes, yung ating SSO dun sa Animang Paes, yung asawa ng Student Services Vice President sa IUP. Win! Sabi niya, yung teacher mo nung high school ka, si Ma'am Abla, nag-missionary siya pagkaritahan niya doon sa isang island, and they successfully avoided cooking Sabbath on the cafeteria. Huh? How, Ma'am? They put the food under the ground so that it will keep warm. Oh! Pwede. Sabi naman ni Bender Sadol, Sir, yung mga ninuno ko, hindi nagluluto pag Sabbath. Akala ko ba hindi tinuturo dito sa Pilipinas? Tinuturo para ng mga missionary. Bakit ngayon hindi natin alam? Nakalimutan. Kaya pala ang sabi sa Fourth Commandment, remember. But God is restoring the truth to our church. Dati yung mga preacher na maliliit na katulad ko, ngayon narinig ko sa IAS, yung mga leader natin, SSD, si Pastor itong mga to, mga may doctor sa theology. So, sa sinabi ko kay mami ko, tingnan ko kung kaya ni mami ko. Kaya ni mami ko, most of the food, most of the time, she is able to cook before Sabbath. Sometimes, pag nalilate sila. So, it's not perfect, but it's better than nothing, right? We are growing. Oh, saan pa? Sabi ko sa isang cafeteria, sa isang Adventist institution, kaya namin yung gawin, sir, kung meron lang kaming malaking ref. Oh. Sabi naman ng mga Tagalight missionary, si Jacob Bayona, doon sir sa light, talagang Friday pa lang dinidistribute na namin yung mga tinapay. At walang preparation and cooking of food. Oh, it is possible. Sabi naman ni Kuya Jun, yung aking mga kaibigan sa probinsya, yung kaldero nilalagyan ng dayami. Oh, para hindi lumamig. Oh, sabi naman niya isang kachat ko dun sa internet. Sabi niya, it's a matter of cooking ahead of time. Sabi ni Dan Bison, yung kachat ko sa internet, we can do it. It will prepare everything on Friday and it's a blessing. We don't have to shout at each other on Sabbath morning and come late to church. Sabi naman ni Jerry Tulog, alam niyo pag sinisalman ko to, natatakot akong hindi na ako babakabatuhin ako ng mga brethren. Pero ang lumalabas, may mga testimony. Marami palang gumagawa nito na patago. Hindi lang nila sinasabi dahil baka sila'y pagalitan. Sabihin offshoot o reform o extremist. Pero nakasulat eh. Hindi naman yan sinabi ng Parisi. Hindi naman yan sinabi ng N.G. White. Sinabi ni Moses. God himself scolded Moses when the Israelites did not obey. So, sabi naman ni Jerry, fasting. Mas madali ito. Yung mga rayuma pa natin, gagaling pa yan. Alam niyo, nakakagaling ng mga ano yung acid dito sa tuhod? Uric acid? Nakakatanggal daw yan. Kaya, tsaka, nung isang semester akong hindi kumain ng buong Sabado, ginamit ako ng Diyos na makatulong mga church plant ng dalawang church plant. Makatulong lang, hindi ako talaga. At tsaka, maging speaker ng dalawang evangelistic. Sabi ko, wala naman nagbago sa akin. But it is true. If you read the Bible, spiritual prophecy, when you fast, God will put you in more useful in your work. Okay. Siya sabi naman ni Ryan James Jimenez, eat fresh fruits and vegetables lang, veggies. Sabi ni Rivera, palay leaves daw ang pinang iikot. Sabi naman ni Joy, kung may ref, pwede. Kaya pala yung ibang church, ayaw rin maghugas ng pinggan. Nilalagyan lang ng plastic. Ah. Pero dun sa isang church, sabi ko, tingnan ko nga kung talagang masusunod nila. Sabi kasi sa Adventist.org, avoid washing dishes. Pumunta ako dun, nag-wash sila ng dish, pero kanya-kanyang wash. Sabi ko, hindi nga naman dishes yun, dish lang. Pwede ba yun mga kapatid? Ah, dish lang eh. Kanya-kanyang hugas. At least hindi dishes. Hindi ko alam, aking interpretation lang po yun. Pero ang nakasulat sa Adventist.org, avoid washing dishes. Ang dali lang naman bumili ng maraming pinggan. Para lang hindi tayo lumubag sa utos ng Diyos. Ano man naman ang mga pinggan. Di ba? What is too hard in exchange for salvation? Sabi naman ni itong isang elder sa nag-chat sa akin sa Facebook, pagka-post ko ng mga matitigas ng mga sermon ko na natatakot akong i-post, pinost ko, pinanood nila. Sabi nila, sir, yung aming elder, father-in-law, 28 years nang hindi nagluluto ng Sabat. Oh, pwede pala. Napakarami ng example mga kaibigan. Ito pa, read, ano to? Youth conference. Hindi rin sila, nag-success din silang hindi magluto ng Sabat. So my question is it possible?
Possible,
okay. Si Dr. Tam daw, sabi ni Mac, alas 4 pa lang, lahat na nung sasakyan nandun na. Tapos napatugtog na siya doon ng ano, music. Tapos yung mga galing sa vegan restaurant, nandun na daw. At dinadala niya siguro dito sa church pagkakinabukasan para marami pang pagpalain. Tapos ito yung president ng ano. Sabi ko, sir, president ng UNCLUB, how do? You know, we have a menu for Sabat. Oh, so ang menu nila for Sabat is yung ginagawa for Friday, it's the menu that doesn't spoil. Sabi naman ng iba, we have a special kaldero for Sabat. Kasi yung kalderong napanisan na, madali na mapanis. So meron silang kaldero na hindi pa napanisan, kahit dalawang araw, hindi pa yun panis. Ah, kaldero lang pala, makakasunod na tayo. So, wala nang excuse. Tingnan natin sa Bible. Sabi ng Bible, bake that which we will bake, seat that which we will seat. Pinagalitan si Moses. How long will you refuse to keep my commandments? My question, did the Ten Commandments change? Did when the punishment for adultery changed, did adultery become not a sin? Dati yung adultery, binabato. Hindi na. Nagbago ba ang Ten Commandments nung pinalitan yung punishment? No. Adultery pa rin yun. Yung Sabbath ba nagbago? Yung Sabbath keeping ba? Nakalimutan. Yun, remember. Ano naman sabi ni Sister White for affirmation that our interpretation is correct? Sabi niya, those who cook food upon the Sabbath violate the fourth commandment and are transgressors of the law. Wow! Most recent instruction. I grew up in an Adventist school. Sabi nila, mahirap kasi noon magluto. Pero hinahanap ko yung excuse na yan sa ating documents. Wala! Sabi ko, sabi-sabi lang pala yun. If it's not written, hindi ayon, sino naman ano. So I preach what is written, bahala na kung ano mangyari. And sabi sa Adventist.org, buying and preparation of food, Adventist.org cannot do anything else but obey the Bible. Okay, yan. Okay. So, yun. Ang ating, paano naman yung mga nurse? Jesus healed on the Sabbath, right? So we heal also on the Sabbath. So that sa mamsi yung mga outpatient close pag Sabbath. But the things that supposed to keep life continuing are okay. How about yung pagliligo pag Sabbath? Oh, naligo ako. Alam nyo kung ano excuse ko. Sabi ni Ellen G. White, you should do everything possible to make the sick comfortable. Paano ko nakabit yun sa pagliligo? Noong unang panahon, si Moses at yung Israelites, maliligo lang sila pagbibigay yung Ten Commandments, right? Di ba? Maligo kayo, God will give the Ten Commandments. So naligo sila. Kung sasabihan lang sila ng Diyos maligo. Ibig sabihin siguro, malinis pa ang mundo noon. Noong panahon ni Ellen G. White, sabi niya, maligo kayo at least 2 times a week. Oh! At least naman. Ngayon, 3 times a day. Bakit? We are sick. Ah, may excuse tayo. We are sick. Our environment is sick. Therefore, we have to make everything possible for the comfort of those who are sick. Our sick is sickness is body odor. Oh. So, okay lang maligo. Kung if you are not sick, if you try, you're not taking a bath, and then you can survive, like some people, they can survive without taking a bath. No. Their friends can survive without them taking a bath. Then they are not sick. They can skip, right? But as we are, most of us, we are sick. Okay. May lusot? Meron. Tama naman eh, we are sick. Okay, stewardship, that's why we go give in offering, because when somebody looks at us, they will also give, right? Like the woman with two mites. Jesus said, siya ang pinakamaraming binigay. Si Jesus pag nagsasabi, kahit hindi totoo, nagiging totoo. That's the power of the Word of God. So how did that become true? According to writings of Ellen G. White under the title sa Harvest and Gathering, lahat ng nagbibigay because of the influence of the woman with two mites, nakakredit lahat ng binibigay nila sa woman. Wow! Ang laki nun! Hanggang ngayon, ang dami na inspire magbigay because of the woman with two mites. Nakakredit yun sa kanya. Kaya kahit 2 piso lang yung ating ilalagay, baka may manood. Baka may nakatingin. Okay. Stewardship. Christian behavior. Ayan. Bibilisan ko ito. Madali lang ito. Hindi, wala namang nagiinom sa inyo. Wala namang nagsusugal. Pero, this means that our amusement and entertainment should meet the highest standards of Christian taste and beauty. Ang galing ng pagpagkasabi is very positive. Hindi sa atake. Pero nakalagay, highest! I have a question. Does boxing, isn't it included in the highest standards of Christian taste and beauty?
No.
Oh, very good. Ang galing ng sagot niyo, pero maraming hindi makasagot. Kaya pala sa Mindoro, nung nagbinyag kayo sa Voice of Youth, sabi ni Pastor, huwag na kayong pupunta sa videoke. Oh, bawal pa naman videoke. Ang lakas pa naman ng boses ko sa videoke. Kaya pagbalik namin, hindi na talaga ako nagbibideoke. Oo nga no. Kasi pala yung background doon, ay hindi, ano, hindi mabuti ang tanawin. Kaya pala ganun. Dahil nakasulat sa fundamental belief, highest standards of Christian taste and beauty. Wow! Fundamental belief pa lang yun. Bawal talaga mag-nood ng boxing. Bawal mag-boxing, alam natin. Pero manood, baka pwede. Sabi sa Romans 1, yung mga brutal, they will not enter into heaven because they are destroying the image of God. Di ba? We are created in the image of God. Pag sinuntok mo, you are destroying the image of God. Tama. Tama naman. Sa Romans. Pero sabi dun sa last verse ng Romans, ito pakinggan nyo mga kapatid. Not only they that do, but also them that have pleasure in them that do them. Yung natutuwa, pag nakatama, whoo! Kasama sa judgment. Nako! Nako! Hindi lang pala yung natutuwa sa gumagawa ng brutality, pati yung, ay hindi lang yung gumagawa, pati yung natutuwa. Kaya, mag-drive na lang tayo pag may laban. Kasi walang traffic. Walang traffic sa EDSA, sa expressway. Okay. Ito naman. And, along with adequate exercise and rest, to adopt the most helpful diet. Di ba meron tayong unhealthful? Yung bawal sa Leviticus 11. Yung baboy, yung mga bagay na, alam nyo naman yun, nasa evangelistic. Pero meron part ng Leviticus 11 na hindi natin binabasa masyado. Yung bandang part na 25 to 30 something. Sabi doon, ang idea, pag ang clean ay nadikitan ng unclean, nagiging unclean yung clean. Example, yung apple, clean, right? Ilagay nyo sa, anong pinaka-poisonous ngayon, alam nyo. Yung pinanglalason ng CIA. O kahit ano, ilagay nyo sa mercury. Clean ng apple o hindi?
Unclean.
Unclean na, kasi dumikit dun sa unclean, right? Kaya sabi ng GMA 7, Inquirer, Laguna Lake is not safe for human and fish.
Huh?
Kaya, pagkakain kayo ng isda, tatanungin nyo kung saan galing yung isda. Galing ka ba sa Laguna Lake? Oh, may kinain ka bang antibiotic na may ganto o may feeds na giniling-giling na baboy? Oh. So, kaya pala yung mga dating clean, nilelecture ni Dr. Tang hindi na daw clean ngayon. Nasaan yung explanation sa Bible? Nandun sa Leviticus 11. Dahil yung mga nadidikitan na hindi na clean, ay naging unclean. Okay. And, di ba merong, yun yung unclean. Tapos merong acceptable. Oh, manok. Kung pinalaki nyo sa likod ng bahay nyo, sigurado kayong walang kinain na mga bagay. Puro kanin lang pinakain nyo. Pwede. Acceptable, right? Pero meron tayong best. Yan yung binulit-lecture ni Dr. Tang. Best vegetarian. Best, right? Anong nakasulat sa fundamental belief? Acceptable, unacceptable, o best? Best. Ayan ang nakalagay. The most helpful diet. Wow! Lahat pala ng Adventist dapat, vegetarian. Kung susundin yun. Kaya lang yung evangelistic crusade na na-attendan natin, 2 weeks lang, hindi na-lecture ang teach them all things. Diba? Great Commission, go, teach, baptize, teach all things. Hindi na-lecture lahat. Mabuti na lang yung Amazing Facts, at least 28 na lecture. Kaya, mabuti na lang yung sa Sabbath School, nililecture din lahat. Kaya lang yung Sabbath School minsan, hindi school eh. May nagiging review center. May ikli lang. Dapat school yun. Marriage in the family, the Bible says, buti na lang, sabi ng Bible, husbands, love your wife as God loves the church. Wives, submit. Ano yung isang term? Magpasako. Children, obey your parents in the Lord. Wow, very nice. For this is right. And Jesus Christ is ministering to us in the heavenly sanctuary. May nagsasabi nito, there is no heavenly sanctuary. Maybe there is no sanctuary in heaven that looks like the one in earth. But when you define sanctuary, it's the house of God. So, there mean in heaven, there is no house of God? How come? So, God, Jesus Christ is ministering in the heavenly sanctuary. And we believe in the second coming in imminent. Yung iba, binibilang nila yung Pope. Pero pinili nila kung aling binibilang. Kasi pag binilang niya yung Pope, daan-daan yan, hundreds yan, since 17-something. So, may nakita kasi ang graph. Totoo kaya yun? So, sabi ng DRI, sino nagsabi kung aling paano mo bibilangin yung Pope? Yung Pope? Bakit yung iba lang yung binilang mo, yung iba hindi binilang? Ah, okay, okay. That's not an official Adventist explanation. But it is imminent. Imminent in the dictionary means almost to happen. And we believe in death and resurrection. That's why when your Lola says that your Lolo is talking to her again, please read Ecclesiastes 9:5, right? Because the dead know not anything. And there is 1,000 years of auditing in heaven. Sinong mga accountant dito? Audit, audit to sa langit. Audit, we are going to judge angels and men, the fallen angels and men. We are going to review. Why? Millennium and the end of sin. Pag tinipe nyo sa N.G. White writing 6,000 years, makikita nyo, 6,000 years yung demo ni Satanas dito sa mundo ng kanyang proposal. So pag binilang nyo yung creation, negative 4,000. Ngayon, positive 2,000. 6,000 na. Ang sunod ay millennium. Medyo late. But the bridegroom cometh. Late. There is delay so that other people who have to repent will repent, right? Okay. But it is not to say that it is exact. Because the Bible says we know not the time. Ellen G. White says we don't know also. But God will announce later. It will sound like thunder to those who don't believe, and it will be clear to those who believe. And we are going to the new earth, praise the Lord, where there is no more non-vegetarian. Pati ba naman yung vegetarianism nakarating sa New Earth? Sabi kasi ng iba, maraming mga karating sa langit na hindi vegetarian. Sabi, ano nga kainin nila dun? Habulin nila yung malaking manok dun. May mingwit sila ng isda. We have to change. The character has to be changed here. Right? But if you don't know, like Martin Luther, he didn't know about the Sabbath. So, but Ellen G. White still speaks nicely about him. Okay, now that's the introduction. Alam niyo na hindi ako offshoot. But maybe nasubrahan na kayo ng banat, so I will tell you nice stories. I have a book here. Adventism's Greatest Need, the Outpouring of the Holy Spirit. At pasensya na kayo, maraming bookmark. Ito yung magagandang kwento. I will tell you one story. Si Pavel, page 211. If I tell it, it lasts 10 minutes. If I read it, it will last 2 minutes. Si Pavel po ay isang elder ng isang church. Siya ay napagkakatiwalaan na elder, and the pastors really trust him. They put him in charge of the church. He is rich. He makes about $500,000 a year on his business. He had been faithful. Ang author po nito ay si Ron M. E. Cluzet, E.M. Cluzet. I think currently he is the evangelism director or something, field secretary of the North American Division. He spoke for 2 weeks at IAS, and I listened to almost all his sermons. And when I got his book, it's really true. So si Pavel ay faithful Adventist. He had been faithful to God in everything he knew. Reaching education, advancement. Wait, do you know Pavel's story? Okay, good. If you know, we'll skip. Risking education, advancement, and opportunities to honor the Sabbath. Nandyan po yung spelling. Siyempre, alam ko, you are like the Bereans. You will Google it first before you believe, right? Google nyo. I-friend nyo siya sa Facebook. Friend ko na siya sa Facebook. Buhay ang tao na yan. Totoo. He was the student of Pastor Ron Cluzet in Southern Adventist University. In the graduate school. God rewarded such faithfulness to honor the Sabbath and other Bible teachings. God rewarded his such faithfulness by placing him as an owner of a sewing business which made serious money. He was taking in more than $500,000 a year and was poised in association with a German company to quadruple that income. So, $500,000 times 4, $2 million. Pero bago siya pumirma, ang mga faithful Adventists, before they sign, they pray. Right? Very good. As they were asking God whether or not to take the step in business, the conference called him to be a full-time pastor. Siguro kulang yung pastor. They had no clue what he was making. A pastor's salary was $250 a month. A tenth of 1% of his potential income. Oh? He and Dana, his wife, decided to surrender all to Jesus. Grabe. I didn't understand this surrender all until I read this story. When I heard it, I believed. I said, let me read. But when I read it, it's true. And then I befriended him. I listened to other sermons. And the book that you can see in the internet, they sold their nice home. Oh, napakaseryoso naman ito. Nakita niya sa Bible, sell all that you have and give to the poor. They actually sold their nice home. And cars. German cars too. And gave away practically everything they owned. Wow. When I heard it in IS, I said, maybe he just hid it somewhere. But when I read it in the book, man, they gave away practically everything they owned. They bought an old Russian jalopy, a little box on wheels as to not make their members envious. Kasi pag naka-BMW yung pastor, maingit yung mga member. He knows it's not supposed to be because Jesus did not ride a chariot. He walked with men, right? Came to their level. But they found that their four church district to be a complete mess. Jealousy and gossip ran high and struggles for leadership power were the business of the day. Acrid argumentation was common over small items such as the worship service. The churches appeared to be everything except a community that followed Jesus. The new pastor wondered how could he bring new people to those new churches. So, gusto niyang ma-increase yung membership. He decided to practice the fundamentals. He encouraged families to gather together for seasons of prayer. As they knelt together, they began to realize the true condition of their own hearts And this led them to confession and surrender. As a body of believers, they entreated the healing power of the Holy Spirit to rule supreme in their personal lives as a blessing to the church. What happened? Within 2 years, the membership doubled. Wow! Fundamentals, prayer, Bible study, missionary work, Holy Spirit, membership doubled in 2 years. As they reached out to friend and neighbor, they added a new congregation and 2 new companies to the district. This kind of progress doesn't go unnoticed by the enemy of souls. May plano si Pastor Pavel, God is blessing, ngunit may plano rin ng kaaway. Satan also has an attack. As he was preparing for the next evangelistic series, he was driving outside the town Otelo, Rusu. One day, a teen decided to cross the highway without looking in his direction. The car struck this boy's hip, and him flying up in the air, only for him to land right in front of Pavel. Also, yung kasalubong nakabangga. Tinamaan sa hip, lumanding sa harap ni kotse ng kotseng karag-karag ni Pastor Pavel. Too late to avoid his hitting the boy again, this time on his head and shoulders. His brain, the teenager's body was a crumpled mess with blood running out of his ears, nose, mouth, and eyes. He was rushed to the hospital. His brain hemorrhaged profusely. His spine was broken in 2 places. One of his lungs was punctured. He had a broken hip, broken arm, broken leg. A team of physicians, by the way, this is in Romania, a communist country. It's not easy to be an Adventist, faithful Adventist in communist Romania. A team of physicians did their best to save him, but without success. After he died, they covered him with a cloth, and each one went out of the emergency room, leaving the boy. The name is Mene Mene, M-E-N-E space M-E-N-E. Because you are going to type it in Google, right? And each one filed out of to be taken to the morgue later. So tinignan ko sa Google, talaga palang dinala niya sa morgue, dinala na sa morgue sa hospital. Nandun na siya sa mga metal. Poor Mene Mene is a 19-year-old, well-known in town. Suffering from motor coordination deficiencies, he couldn't control his arms or legs well and had come close to being killed crossing the street on more than one occasion. People had given him his nickname to ridicule his stuttering problem. Now, the problem is the Adventist pastor is the one who killed him. This is a very popular guy because of his disabilities. Now, Pavel was devastated by the loss of that innocent young life and the damage to the cause of God when the Spirit was blessing them so much. So, Pastor Pavel went to many men's bed, and this is his prayer. I want to read word for word. God, what are the people of Otelo Rusu going to say when they hear that I killed a young man just beginning his life? They know I'm a pastor. What will they think? If need be, I am willing to exchange my life for his. Let me explain. Sometimes you love somebody so much, and you are not sure they are going to be saved. You want rather to die than them to die, right? That's what Pastor Pavel was thinking. I'm willing to exchange my life for his. I know you are able to bring him back to life if you choose. Huh? I don't know. I know you are able to bring him back to life if you choose. Okay, listen to the next sentence. I am asking you, please bring him back. Please, God, please. Huh? Pastor Pavel, Adventist pastor, pinapabuhay niya sa Diyos yung kanyang nabangga. Okay. One of the doctors caught him praying and told him to go home. He assured Pavel that the boy was very dead, and that it was too late to pray for him now. Just face it, it's over, according to the doctor. But Pavel believed in a bigger God than those communist doctors had ever dreamed of. Back home, he and his wife spent the entire night pleading before God that if there was any way to restore the young man's life, for God's honor and glory, to please do it. And they accepted God's will whichever way they went. This is the attitude that is very nice. Whether God says yes, whether God says no, we accept the result. We accept God's answer because it is for God's glory. But we have our request. Please, Lord, please pakibuhay. See, many, many. Okay, in the morning, Pavel, Pastor Pavel returned to the hospital to meet with the family. Makikipag-regular siguro. But instead, found a commotion around many, many who was sitting up in bed eating. Google. Namaya, nag-google nyo. He was alive. A host of medical professionals crowded into the room, bewildered, comparing x-rays from that morning to the ones taken the day before. To the inexplicable amazement of everyone, the new x-rays showed absolutely no damage whatsoever to the brain, the spine, the hip, or the lungs. The young man had only a broken arm and a leg. May natira pa. Para siguro, hindi sabihin, hindi yan yung kagabi. Meron pa rin. Oh, tinignan ko sa Google, nakita ko yung book doon. Sa Google, Google Scholar, hindi mo makikita lahat, you have to buy. And you buy it, you know, because Pastor Pavel has, you know, easy royalty, you know. Like Ellen G. White books, you know, Ellen G. White was selling Great Controversy and so on. You pay, right? Don't download, yeah? We have to be good example, right? So I saw in that book, the book of Pastor Pavel's life, nilagay talaga siya sa morgue. Pero nakita ng iba, bakit may nakaupo dun sa stainless? Yung mga nakaupo, sa room yun dapat, hindi dun sa stainless. So binalik siya dun sa room. There is us, in John, it says, this Jesus prophesies, these things which I do, ye shall also do. Not only this, but more. So in the last days, if Jesus did these things, we are going to do, suppose, if you believe. You know, if you believe in me, these things which I do, you shall also do, but more. So these things are happening. The young man, okay, had only a broken. In addition, his speech was perfect for the first time in his life. No more stuttering problem. Wow. The stutter was gone, and when the teen was discharged, they saw that he had full control of his arms and legs. Another miracle. Wow! Kaya, kung tayo may kapansanan, hintayin lang natin kung kaya gagamitin ng Diyos. Diba? Si Pablo, he wrote almost half of New Testament. He was praying in Corinthians, remove this thorn from my flesh. But God did not remove. Because sabi ng Diyos, because of the multitude of revelations, I will not remove. Because you might become proud. My grace is sufficient for thee. In Tagalog, matuwa ka nang maliligtas ka. Huwag ka na magreklamo. Baka yumabang ka pa. Pag ikay matuwid, walang problema sa katawan. Okay. So, galing nyo. What did you learn? He was serious guy. So sabi ko, bakit pa ako nananalangin parang hindi pinapansin ng Diyos? Because I did not sacrifice $2 million. I did not sell everything I have and give to the poor. So if you are serious, Pastor Pavel was serious with his religion. God was also serious with him. Grabe. Yun pala yung sabi ni Jesus Christ sa rich young ruler. Sell all that you have and give to the poor. So the blessings are in proportion to self-sacrifice. The multitude of them believe in one heart. Kaya pag nag-evangelism tayo, nobody thinks it is his own mixer or his own microphone or his own piano or his own violin or his own projector or his own speaker. Everything was, they had all things in common, right? When we do evangelism, who cares whose car is it? Just go, right? Diba? And with great power gave the apostles witness to the resurrection of the Lord Jesus. And great grace was upon them all because blessings are in proportion to self-sacrifice. He who soweth sparingly shall also reap sparingly. Okay, what happened to Pastor Pavel? Nung nabangga si Pavel, si Menemene, sikat si Menemene, nung nabangga, mas sikat pa. Namatay na yung stuttering guy. Sino nakapatay? Si Pastor Pavel. Nung nabuhay, mas lalong sikat pa. So nung crusade si Pastor Pavel, puno ang church hanggang sa labas. At ang daming nagtatanong ng question. You can imagine the news in town. And when the evangelistic meeting began, the whole area turned out for them, filling the church with many staying for questions after its presentation. The result, the church doubled its membership again. That is what happens when the Holy Spirit is poured out on us. And there are things that drive away the spirit. Number one is, I hope it is here. Yan. Amusements are doing more to counteract the working of the Holy Spirit than anything else. Wow! Movie, games, in the cell phone also. Pero merong innocent amusements sa writings ni Ellen G. White. Paano malaman na innocent? Nandun sa Philippians 4. Whatsoever is true, whatsoever is lovely, angry. Hindi kasama yung angry. Whatsoever is true. So yung fiction, hindi nakasama yung mga fiction sa National Bookstore. Mga fiction ng mga movie. Of good report, yung mga bad report sa news. Huwag nyo na panoorin kasi yung advertisement, may rock music at saka may mga kung ano na nakikita. Lock nyo na lang yung TV nyo sa 45. Diba? At least, pag may nakita kayong hindi maganda doon, pwede nung sawayin si Pastor Orbe. Kaibigan natin, si Sir, ano, sino na nga yung dito? Yung mga kaibigan natin doon. Okay, so, amusements are doing more to counteract the working of the Holy Spirit than anything else. Do you think God will pour His Holy Spirit to people who don't obey? No, you have to obey. You have to ask for the Holy Spirit. Demand the outpouring of the Holy Spirit. And God will use us. Okay. 12:2 na. So, we don't have time for all of this. Let me just close with the verse that says here that more things are going to happen. It says, John 14:12. It says, verily, verily, I say unto you, he that believeth on me, the works that I do, he shall also do. And greater works than this shall he do, because I go to my Father in heaven. Yan po. Ang daming ginagawa ng Diyos. Kanina yung kanta natin na God is doing many things. Itong mga bookmarks, lahat ganun na kwento. Ang dami niyan. Kaya lang, we have to go and do, right? So let us all pray for our closing, close this sermon. Our Father in heaven, we thank you, Lord, for the truth in the Bible. We thank you, Lord, for prophecy where we find our church, our movement. We thank you, Lord, for the truth that corrects our wrong thinking, corrects our wrong lifestyle, corrects the things that we do not know how to correct, Lord. Our Father, we thank you, Lord, for the power of the Holy Spirit, the changing power of your word that changes us, that sanctifies us, Lord. We ask, Lord, that you forgive us from all our sins. We did not know many things we were doing, but you forgive us, Lord. We are eternally grateful, Lord, for the salvation that you are offering us. Help us, Lord. We are weak. We cannot do it by ourselves. We need to hold on you, Lord, because the enemy is very powerful. We don't understand ourselves. We are fallen nature, and the influences in this world are also going to the other side. Without you, Lord, we cannot survive in our spiritual life in this great controversy. But with you, Lord, you are our only hope. Lord, please help us. Hold our hand as we do your word. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.